Hey everyone, and welcome back to another Will's Week in Whiskey, the weekly YouTube show brought to you by the podcast where I bring you the headlines and happenings of the week in the world of whiskey. So we've got some announcements of some special products coming up, some other fun things. I can't wait to get to it. First, we're going to talk about a special limited edition release from the Jack Daniel's Distillery out of Lynchburg, Tennessee. This is a single barrel, barrel proof rye. It's only going to be about 200 barrels making up this limited edition. It's that new mash bill they came out with a few years back of their rye, which was the first Jack Daniel's mash bill since Prohibition to be introduced. It's going to be around $64.99, and it's going to hit shelves at the end of this month of November. Now, it's going to be interesting because a 200 barrel batch makes it a very limited edition. I love their single barrel rye that you can get as a store pick and as just a regular offering, and I love the concept of having it at a higher proof. They had the Tennessee Taster selection about a year ago that was a barrel proof rye, and I really liked it, so I'm looking forward to trying this one. We're actually going to get some media samples and try it over on the podcast, so I look forward to getting to try that. And I enjoy these releases from the Jack Daniel's Distillery, and I hope that more people will be able to get offerings like this from them. Next, we have an interesting move in marketing. Now, the storied brand Rebel Yell is dropping the Yell from their name. Now, this wasn't announced in a press release. This wasn't something that they have gone out yet and kind of touted, but it has started to happen amongst their social media accounts. The website is now just rebelbourbon.com, and they even have on the website what the labels will look like. It's just Rebel, no Yell. Now, this is a historic brand. This was a part of the Stitzel-Weller lineup, that historic brand. Now, it does have Confederate connotations. It's Rebel Yell. It was originally on the label. It said expressly for the Deep South. And so I can understand why a company in the current climate may want to detach themselves a little bit from that imagery. However, I do find it a bit curious that they've just started slowly doing this and not making an announcement about it, as you would see with many brands when they decide to make a big shift in their marketing. Now, the Rebel Yell I've still seen on the shelves carries that branding that they reintroduced last year in about April of 2019. And that's around the same time they released that Rebel Yell 100, which is a bargain bourbon. It's like $13 or $14 for 100 proof weeder. It's really good, and I like it. It's going to be interesting to see how this is received, especially as it seems to be a politically correct move in this climate, but without them explaining their decision to make this move. So it'll be interesting to see how it's received and what other things come out, or if they do, once they start hitting the shelves, make a big announcement about it. But you can see the imagery of all their products, their rye, their bourbon, the 100 proof bourbon, and even the 10-year single barrel, which I love. I have a bottle of right now with the old branding that I just picked up from the shop a couple weeks back, and I love that bourbon, and I will continue to enjoy it. But once again, just an interesting thing I've noticed from both their social media, from the emails that I get from the company. It is now just Rebel Bourbon, no more Rebel Yell. It will be curious to see if someone tries to claim that's an abandoned trademark and then tries to pick up that mantle and take some of the Stitzel-Weller story and use that, because it does have ties to the most famous distillery in all of bourbon. Now, we have gotten another announcement out of Buffalo Trace. There is a new vintage in the OFC lineup. This is 1995. That means it was distilled in 1995, 25 years ago, and it is being bottled this year. It is a 90-proof bourbon. It is only 1,500 bottles of this 25-year-old release. It will retail for $2,500. These come in a crystal decanter. They have OFC, which is the original name of the distillery at Buffalo Trace. You even see OFC on warehouse, the tornado surviving warehouse C. There is a lot of imagery and story with this brand that goes all the way back to Colonel Taylor himself. So we will see this come out, but not many of us will see it on our shelves. At that price tag, it is definitely a luxury item. It comes in that wood display case. And I have gotten the privilege to try the 1994 vintage, which came out last year. It was definitely a remarkable bourbon. It had everything you're looking for a luxurious pour. And I hopefully one day we'll get to try another OFC vintage, but it's not something I feel like I'll be able to find very easily, nor do I know if I will spring for the $2,500 price tag for a full bottle. I do think if you are really into bourbon and you have the means, buying a pour of this at a bar, if you can find it, is going to be a memorable experience. So keep an eye out if you're in the market for that. Now, finally, this is some other news, and the St. Jude's Children's Hospital puts on a annual fundraiser and auctions off items. Buffalo Trace has always been heavily involved with raising money for St. Jude's, and what they have done now is offer a VIP experience at the distillery. It's going on now through December 3rd at 8 p.m. if you want to get involved in this, but they are offering up a stay at the new lodge that's up on the farm on property of the distillery, a tasting and tour and catered meal and all sorts of fun happenings. But the best part is that you will be picking the very first barrel ever offered of Stagg Jr. as a barrel pick. They say that there'll be the 4-barrel lineup. You will pick it, and that barrel will be the first. Now, that begs the question. Does it by first mean those are coming? Let's hope so. It very much seems that way. Then instead of them saying an exclusive once-in-a-lifetime opportunity never to be offered again, but they didn't explicitly say that. We do know that this will be the first. It's a cask strength offering, so we know the yield on that is going to be lower than it may normally be. So that person who is fortunate enough to win that auction is going to get to have an experience with a group of friends and go stay at the lodge, which is incredible. I've gotten to see it in person. And they're going to get this once-in-a-lifetime first-ever Stagg Jr. barrel pick. Now, as of time of recording, that bid for that experience, not including the barrel, is already up to over $15,000. It's for a great cause. So if that is something that you want, this exclusive experience, and you have the means to do it, it's going for a great cause. I would highly recommend looking into doing that. And you can find that at the Podcasters group. I posted a link to it. Or if you just search the St. Jude's auction or many other places, I'm sure you'll be able to find it. And I'll put the link in the description below. Thank you so much for watching this Will's Week in Whiskey. I hope you enjoyed it. Hope you learned something. And I can't wait to bring you more content like this. If you don't listen to the podcast, check us out at thepodcast.com or wherever you get your podcasts. We'd love for you to listen and leave us a rating and review. And if you don't subscribe to this YouTube channel, go ahead and subscribe. Ring the bell so you get notifications when we post new videos. And we will continue bringing you good content like this. So thank you all for watching, and I'll catch you next week on Will's Week in Whiskey.